Are we ready?
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to another talk show with Little Wings Holistic Childhood Center. And today we have with us one of the very renowned choreographer from the industry. He has been associated with many great projects. So let's start the show on this note. A very good evening to everyone. Today we have with us Diplav Shah. He's a renowned name in the talent industry. He's a choreographer by profession. Welcome to the show, Diplav sir. A warm welcome to
you. Thank you so much, Nikita ma'am. Thank you so much. Hi, everyone.
Yeah, I would like to introduce few of things in his kitty, which is like one of his signature act, that is Diya act, which he has performed. His team has performed, I'll put up under the guidance, India's Got Talent 4 in the season, fourth season. And the same act was performed on the global platform in 2019 in China under the banner of World's Got Talent.
True.
Amazing. And also not to forget that Diplav and his team has been instrumented in the landmark dance recital Ghoomar in Padmavat, directed by Sanjay Leela Bansali. A very warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Nikita.
How are you?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm good. Thank you. As you are one of the youngest entrepreneurs in Ahmedabad, and you are into training thousands of students across the country through your passion for dance as a choreographer. And let me just say that children and parents who are associated with Little Wings on these grounds are fortunate enough to have you with us as a trainer on board.
My pleasure.
Yes, sir. Sir, I would want to know first and foremost that you have been associated with Bollywood, with celebrities, with reality shows. What made you join Little Wings Holistic Childhood Center?
Lovely question, Nikita ma'am. I would like to say that I've been training loads of professional artists. I've been training a lot of Bollywood celebrities. I've been training a lot of students. But then when it comes to the toddlers and kids, it reminds me of my childhood. And the energy and the vibrations that you get from children, they're so fresh, they're so good that the moments and the learning process that I get into with these children is so much fun. And I learn so much from them. Though they're so tiny little toddlers who hardly walk or barely move, but then things that I grab from them and they learn from me, the entire process is so entertaining and it's so heartwarming that I love the energy and the vibrations that I get from them. So yeah, the toddlers have been always an integral part of my teaching process. Since years that I have been imparting the dance training, I would say since 10 years I've been training a lot of students. But then yes, when it comes to Little Wings, the basic fundamental of Little Wings, which is the holistic development of a child, wherein they nurture a child right from their basic body language to nurturing their mind, brain development, to their motor skills, everything is there in Little Wings. So yes, dance is also a very important element when it comes to nurturing a child. It enhances a child to learn a lot many things, and it helps in increasing the child motor skills. At the same point of time, it helps a child to think in a better and a different way and express themselves in much better way. So yes, when I got an opportunity and when I got a call from Little Wings that we would like to collaborate, I was very happy and I said, this is an interesting job for me and I would like to take it further with my team. Yeah, so it was a wonderful experience, Nikita ma'am.
Thank you. In fact, we are also glad to have you with us. That means what I understand is that dance is very important for the mental well-being of any child, right?
Correct. It is very important. The body and the mind, they work together. So when we express a child with the music, you know, during their early development, the sounds and the rhythm and the meaning of the words, which they understand and they start expressing. So dancing to the music, you know, helps a child build their motor skills, allowing them to practice their self-expression. So when you ask a child to smile, when you give a child a rhythm to jump, so there are a lot of expressions come out while dancing. You know, when we move our hands and when we talk and when we direct, there are a lot of body expressions which come out. And I think that makes a child look different, and that enhances their inner abilities, which come out very well.
Absolutely true, sir. I would want to know that for this academic year, as you know that pandemic is there and things are going on a hybrid frame where an online education has stepped in. Your journey, what all challenges you have faced when you were training the kids who were there on the campus, I'll put up. Plus, there were kids who were not attending the school from the campus. They were associated with us online. So there must be challenges. As far as I know, education segment has undergone a lot of changes and better things have come up. So when we talk about dance, how you have...
So, Nikitam, I will... Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, you are.
Yeah. So I would say that we are in the times of pandemic, wherein COVID has hit everybody in the country. Now, taking this times into consideration, we have to take a step further. We have to think a notch further. So this is the time of the hybrid evolution, wherein offline and online both have been working parallelly and both have been equally important. So when we have to train the toddlers or we have to train the elders, through an online training program with the help of the technology that is available today. Thanks to all the tech gurus who have invented such good technology with the help of Zoom, with the help of many live platforms, IT portals, we have been able to deliver our training via them to our kids and to our students. So the same goes with Little Wings. We had a lot of challenges when it comes to kids, because for kids to learn something online from a video and capturing their attention and making the entire session for them interesting is a little difficult task for the toddlers. Initially, one or two sessions wherein parents paid a lot of involvement. There was a lot of help from the staff and the teachers which came along with us and the Diplov team, trainers and instructors. Everybody came together and made that 1 hour session so much interesting for the kids that they would not like to miss the session, and they all became a part of it. So the training process happened online also, and whenever we could call a little few kids, taking all the safety precautions in the school premises, we did training with them also for a couple of sessions. So yeah, and eventually we could make a beautiful dance recital video in this difficult times of pandemic, and we did not stop. Though pandemic was there, the show had run. So yeah, we could achieve it.
And the show must go on.
Correct. The show must go on. Definitely, yes.
Exactly. On this note, for our viewers, we would like to showcase a glimpse of the video or the training sessions that has happened on the campus with our toddlers. Let's have a look at it. We have tried to move.
Come now, follow my lead.
Everybody clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands. All right, now, we're going to do the basic step. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. Right foot, let's stomp. Left foot, let's stomp. Cha-cha, real smooth. Turn it out. To the right now. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth. Freeze.
Say you wanna grind, let the rhythm take you over. Zumba, zumba, yeah, zumba, yeah, zumba, yeah. 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 Let me see you boogie boogie, zumba boogie woo. Boogie bala boogie boogie, femme boy boogie woo. Let me see you boogie boogie, zumba boogie woo. Boogie bala boogie boogie, femme boy boogie woo. Boogie woo.
Let me just, am I audible?
By all the children, great effort, you all, Nikita ma'am, and the entire team of it.
Diplab, your voice is a little bit cut. Rahi hai.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is simply mind-blowing, working with kids and, I have simply no words for all our instructors and the people who were here from your troop. True. Clap for them. For everybody, I'll say it was simply amazing.
The entire staff of the wings, everything that children have done together. Amazing work, yeah. With such, like, young toddlers, the way they did yoga and all the forms, very nicely done. Great effort.
Really beautiful. Diplab, aapki awaaz thodi si ruk ruk ke aa rahi hai. If you can just check on your internet.
I will do that, certainly. Are we good now?
You are good now. Absolutely okay. So we were saying the sessions going on and at the campus are simply super. We really don't have any words for it. And great work to your team plus the teachers of Little Wings. Amazing.
Thank you so much.
Now, I'm a little inquisitive on one very important aspect and would like to know from your side, what makes you incorporate yoga and meditation when we talk about this dance as a recital program? In your training sessions, I've seen that a lot of sessions were there on yoga and meditation. Yeah, please.
Okay. So Nikita ma'am, I would like to say that yoga helps one to create a lot of awareness about our inner body, and it helps in enhancing the strength of the body. So when we do yoga practices, it helps to enhance the strength of the body and the flexibility which is required to dance. So okay. Matlab, that is the first step of dance. Okay, if you want to really dance well and want to do good dance movements, so you should be aware of your body and you should be flexible enough to dance properly. So that's how yoga helps. And of course, if you meditate and if you concentrate, it helps a lot for a child to, get a good, real good concentration. So if you can learn well, so in order to, learn the dance thoroughly and properly, if they are practicing yogic movements and if they're practicing yoga, and to make it interesting for them, we combine yoga with, a little bit of dance movements. So it becomes interesting for them and they would love to, have it in their sessions and they would learn yoga in that format. So I would say that dance and yoga goes together. And if children who have had the basics of yoga would be great dancers and enhance their flexibility levels altogether differently.
Okay.
Yeah. So yoga is important. Yeah. They work hand in hand.
True. So definitely now I know that why they were incorporated in different format.
Yeah.
I would also want to know that these dance forms which you have opted, which currently are going on at the campus, it can be Zumba, it can be foundation of dance. Any specific reason behind selecting these formats of dance? But do they contribute for the development, holistic development, or how it is?
So when we're talking about the holistic development of a child, and when I am associated with Little Wings School as in the form of dance, that I had to take care of the holistic development of a child. So when we are taking and we're talking about different dance styles, and which are appropriate to their age and their learning capacity. What happens is, like, when we're talking about yoga or when we're talking about the fundamentals of dance, kids will learn a lot about the basics, the origin of the region, the culture. So that is going to be a holistic development. It is not going to be just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Learning dance, but they're learning about the culture of that particular region. They're learning about the origin of the dance. They're learning about the state. They're learning about the country. They're learning about the styles, cultural values, and not many things. So to begin the toddlers, we start with very basics. Like if I would say one of the fundamentals of dance was about Latin dance style, where we taught cha-cha-cha to our little children. So cha-cha-cha is very much kid-friendly, toddler-friendly dance style, wherein we made them understood that this is a Latin dance style form that we're doing, and the basics of it, and the origin from where it evolved. So a child understands everything, and then they're processing it, and then they're learning the process. So it is an overall holistic development which we're trying to incorporate with the children. If you would say, we try to incorporate semi-classical Indian dance styles also, wherein we try to teach children, certain moves of Bharatanatyam and I would say Kathak movements. So that is wherein we try to touch the kids, teach them where the Kathak dance style has originated from, or where the Bharatanatyam dance style is originated from, how does their movements work. And with these tiny little toddlers, they absorb things so well. They learn things so well that it really immediately clicks to their mind. And then the way they perform and the way they execute, it makes a lot of development. It makes a lot of difference. कोई चीज के बारे में तुम्हें सारी जानकारी है एंड देन यू आर एक्सप्रेसिंग इट द एक्सप्रेशंस कम आउट वेरी डिफरेंटली व्हेन यू डोंट नो अबाउट इट एंड देयर इज जस्ट म्यूजिक व्हिच इज प्लेइंग एंड योर डांसिंग इज वेरी डिफरेंट सो आई वुड से डिफरेंट डांस स्टाइल्स डिफरेंट फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ डांस व्हेन दे आर राइटली बीइंग टॉट टू चिल्ड्रन एट राइट एज इट मेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस इन देयर परफॉर्मेंस ओवरऑल Okay. So that's how it works together.
Okay. So Diplab, tell me how important it is to introduce anything like this at an early age. We are talking about kids who are of age group 3-4, not more than that. Max is 3 to 6. So do you really think that it is very important to introduce, whether it is sports, whether it is education, whether it is dance or any art style, whether we talk about art and craft? Because again, the era we are in currently, delivering these things is quite difficult when we talk about online sessions. So how do you make us understand that? What is the significance of introducing everything at an early age?
Yeah. So, Nikita ma'am, I would say that talking about today's generation, talking about today's era, where things have been so much digitalized, and the early age children, the preschool kids or the toddlers, they have been seeing so many things on television, so many things on screen, on mobile screens or on TV screens, or, anywhere there is so much of digitalization that they see things around. But then when it comes to the real feel of it, when it comes in reality, when you are doing things in real and you're seeing things in virtual, these are two different contradict things. Now, when you're seeing someone dancing on television or on your mobile screen, and you're trying to grab that emotion out into you, and when you're seeing things live in front of you and you're doing it, it makes a lot of difference. When you see a DIY activity which is happening on a channel, on a digital platform, and when you see a DIY activity which is happening wherein an art and craft person is doing in front of you and teaching it to you in person, the overall learning and the process is very different, and it helps very differently to a child. Because it was time of pandemic, a lot of things happened online because we did not wanted to stop the learning process. Though the percentage ratio might have been reduced, it has affected to some extent, but then it at least online platforms helped them to take one step further and not to stop it at all. So yeah, I would suggest that maybe dance, maybe any activity, it is very important to start at an early age of, say, I would say 3.5 and above, till an age of 8 years, because that's the time where a child is like a soft clay. You can mold, you can nourish a child, and you can develop the child. And this is the period when their mind absorbs so many things, and they're so quick in learning and adapting things, that if they're going to have knowledge of music, if they're going to have knowledge of rhythm, if they're going to have knowledge of how to hold the scissors and how to draw a curve or how to draw straight lines, it is going to help them 10 years later in becoming an individual professional altogether and a successful professional. What they've learned now and what they are going to learn in their early age definitely helps them in the overall development of their, when they grow old and when it is really required. Certain things are done at certain age, और वो बोलते हैं ना कि भी कई सारी चीजों के लिए फिर उम्र चली जाती है, फिर वो सीखने का वो एक पैशन नहीं होता है. लेकिन अभी ये एज में ऐसा होता है कि जो भी हमें दे रहे हो आप, सारी चीजें बहुत फ्रेश और नई है उनके लिए. तो एंड दे आर सो एंथुसियास्ट इन लर्निंग ऑल ऑफ इट, द एंथुसियाज्म दैट वी गेट इन देम. एंड सो इट इज चैलेंजिंग फॉर अस एट टाइम्स. वी हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी पेशेंट विद चिल्ड्रन, वेरी पेशेंट विद टॉडलर्स, बट देन व्हेन दे लर्न इट एंड व्हेन दे डू इट, इट इज वंडरफुल. So yeah, it is overall a joyful experience.
Definitely, I do understand. As you are talking about, this will be informative to many of our viewers who ask us ki why this is so important at an early age, why preschool currently, kya zarurat hai, seekh lenge aaram se. So with this, I know that now they'll have an answer, that the early it has been introduced, the more better it is going to be for the kids in their ages, definitely. Yeah. So I would also like to know from your side how dance and music helps a child to groom holistically, or is it helpful for the mental well-being of any individual?
Okay, so I'll say that dance and music, how does it help a child, nurturing holistically? So आई वुड जस्ट गिव एन एग्जांपल, अगर हमें कोई बच्चे को इफ वी वांट अ चाइल्ड टू स्पीक अप वन लाइन, इट इज गोइंग टू बी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द चाइल्ड टू रिमेम्बर दैट लाइन एंड टू रियली यू नो वही चीज को बोलने के लिए अगर हम उन्हें बोलेंगे कि जिस तरीके से हमने बताई वही चीज आप दोहराइए दूसरी बार, तो वो चीज डिफिकल्ट होगी बिकॉज दे आर वर्ड्स, दे आर सेंटेंसेस, दैट्स अ नॉर्मल लैंग्वेज. बट इफ यू मेक इट रिदमेटिक, इफ यू एड म्यूजिक टू इट, इफ यू एड हैंड मूवमेंट्स एंड एक्सप्रेशंस टू इट, इट बिकम्स एंटरटेनिंग फॉर अ चाइल्ड. देयर इज समथिंग दैट दे लव डूइंग इट, एंड व्हेन यू लव व्हाट यू आर डूइंग, द आउटपुट एंड रिजल्ट्स कम डिफरेंटली. Today you have to learn an answer to a question, but what if you learn in the form of a poetry? The same answer can be done in the form of a poetry, and the child would immediately recollect it, remember it, and it will enhance his brain, and the output and the results are going to be different. So the same goes with dance and music. Kids start learning the rhythms and movements into their mind. They start understanding the meaning of the words which come into the music and the songs and the lyrics, and they start expressing themselves. So here, the entire process is like you're listening, you're understanding, your brain is processing, and then you're expressing. Okay. It is not a read and a written thing. It is not something which is mugged up in your mind. It is not something which is being put on in your mouth and you're doing it, put on your mind and you're doing it. It is something when you're understanding yourself, your brain is absorbing it, your entire body is flowing in it, and then you're expressing. So this is going to help them. This process of learning helps them in any different subject altogether. The same process goes for different subjects. And agar yahan se ye basic unhone seekha hoga, jo dance aur music se wo seekh paate hain, jo dance aur music ke lessons se wo log le paate hain, wahi cheez ko fir wo life mein kafi sari jagahon pe वही प्रैक्टिस को आगे लेके जाएंगे तो उनको काफी हेल्पफुल रहेगा. एंड इट रियली मेक्स अ डिफरेंस टू चिल्ड्रन बिकॉज व्हेन यू प्रोसेस समथिंग इन योर ब्रेन स्टार्ट्स एब्जॉर्बिंग इट एंड देन द बॉडी रिएक्ट्स टुवर्ड्स इट एंड देन यू रेसिप्रोकेट टू इट. दैट रिएक्शन इज द एक्चुअल रिएक्शन एंड दैट प्रोसेस इज द एक्चुअल प्रोसेस. सो दैट्स हाउ अ होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट इज बीइंग बिल्ट एंड दैट्स हाउ अ चाइल्ड इज बीइंग नर्चर्ड टुगेदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ डांस एंड म्यूजिक.
सो बेसिकली अ होलसम ग्रूमिंग इज डन एंड एवरीथिंग इज इंपॉर्टेंट.
Correct.
True. Very, very thank you so much. It was really nice talking to you today. And yeah, we are immensely thankful for you have spared your precious time to be with us on this platform of Little Wings. I'm sure today's talk must have given beautiful insights to our parents and the viewers and kids who have been associated with us. And this will definitely help them groom holistically, have that wholesome development when we talk about dance, art, music, and everything. And finally, I would like to end the show with a note that Little Wings takes a proud privilege that we are able to make that happen on the campus of Little Wings. Yeah, sir, aap kuch keh rahe? Yeah. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you, Dipla, for joining us tonight. Thank you for
same being. Yeah. Am I audible?
या यू आर नाउ ऑडिबल. बताइए आप क्या कह रहे थे. आई थिंक द लाइन इज अ लिटिल ट्रबलसम. डिप्लोम सर. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you viewers for joining us tonight. On this note, I would like to end the show. And let me just tell you a very happy new year well in advance. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you so much. Have a great weekend ahead. Thank you. Bye-bye.